Good morning, students. Today we will discuss chapter number 2, fractions and decimal. So see children, here first we will discuss fraction. So see children, first, fraction is a part of whole. Here fraction is a part of whole. Second, fraction is used to represent the part of the whole things. Fraction is used to represent the part of the whole things. For example, 5 by 11. So 11 is whole. And 5 is a part. Means out of 11, 5 part we have to represent. So 5 by 11. So here 5 part we have to represent out of 11. So we can say that fraction is a part of whole. And second, fraction is used to represent the part of the whole things. Third, fraction has two parts. First, numerator and second, denominator. Fraction has two parts. First, numerator and second, denominator. The number on the top is called numerator and the number on the bottom is called denominator. See children, 5 by 11. Here 5 is available on top. So 5 is the numerator and 11 is available on bottom. So 11 is the denominator. So in 5 by 11, 5 is the numerator and 11 is the denominator. Now, next point. Numerator defines the number of equal parts taken or shared. Numerator defines the number of equal parts taken or shared. Here see it. 5 by 11 means 5 parts are shared out of 11 parts. Or 5 parts are taken out of 11 parts. And denominator defines the total number of equal parts in whole. And denominator defines total number of equal part in whole. So here 11 parts are available in whole. So 11 is the denominator. Now see children, fraction is equal to numerator divided by denominator. So 5 by 11, here 5 is the numerator, 11 is the denominator. Now next, write fraction for the following figure. Here two figures are given to us. We have to write fraction for them. So see children, it is first figure. In first figure, there are four total parts. See, it is first, this is once given, this figure is given to us. This is first part, second part, third part and fourth part. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. So total four parts are given to us. So total parts is equal to 4. Now shaded part. How many shaded parts available here? So see, 1, 2, 3. So shaded part is 3. So here in a given figure, there are 4 parts are available. See 1, 2, 3, 4. And so total parts is equal to 4. And shaded part. How many shaded parts are available? 1, 2, 3. So shaded parts are 3. So its fraction is 3 by 4. So shaded part divided by total parts. So 3 by 4 is the fraction. Now second figure. For second figure, first we will identify total parts. So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Total parts are 18. Now we will identify shaded parts. So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So shaded parts are 5. So answer is 5 by 11. Answer is 5 by 18, not 11. Answer is 5 by 18. So see children, this is the normal explanation of introduction of the fraction. I hope you can understand this. Thank you.